And he said he felt a change was coming near. And I said nothing ever changes here. And so we watched for shooting stars. We got some in the shining shower in the morning. We'll never be the same.
Favorite metaphor.
metaphor for family? Could it be hills of golden grass? Could it be presents in the past? Could it be mountains made of clouds? Yeah, the ways we envision the worlds that we want are things that I treasure. They go on, and I know it's simplistic, but there's comfort in change. Some things would be different, some things stay the Mississippi swells I know, ever drawing line to another time, to the sirens of Chicago, or Memphis's eerie glow. Not quite cause you've chosen so, but in dreams you're drawn to drown in such a small town, to your instincts bade you go. And you reflect on things you now know, like how Cindy said it all seems the same. Embedded in patterns you don't notice, the features out of focus, it's a shame. The flashlight just falls in the direction you're headed, but you just knew there's nothing to gain. No measure of light among the sightless, immobilized and righteous, it was pain. So you pointed your beam in the direction of anywhere. And though urbanity was not without its flaws, you found the time and space you'd need to sharpen your claws and hone your eyesight on the skeletons upon which all your little interactions carry on. Those that are visible and not metaphysical and hot, the anatomy of everything. So when I got to your city, it was summer, it was pretty, and we walked around cause we had the time. You remarked on all the places that you hadn't seen in ages, disconnected from the metro city lines. And on the closed doors of the fire stations, testament to forced displacement, shocked me so to see it from the ground. What seems so functional from great heights looking down? But cities observed from planes, at some point so deceptively all start to look the same. You get distracted by the light below the clouds that seems to shine on through the night. You know and how it seems so lit up to some line, feel the brightness so confined, only skyscrapers shine, the tallest buildings do define. Now you wonder the lights you're living under and the vantage points you've yet to even come upon. You dream of transportation infrastructure, the bus stations on the blocks between the shops, lights flicker on and off and on, and my imagination too travels those streets, thinking of places and the people that we meet, and conversations with strangers on bus seats. Like you and Arthur on the 28, 45 fading flip side of the day, and say outside. The living room lamps and the headlights of cars are like fireflies in the night sky. I had a dream our shared experience was tangible. There was a string that just connected me to you. For several thousand miles it stretched into my suit can. I expressed, I feel as though I almost know your name. Story on the wrapper of my chocolate bar about a rare bird and a bear in an endangered space. And I felt as though I'd seen them in a way as though I'd been them. All my empathy embedded in the richness of the taste. It gets easy to look past all the middlemen, all the suits and ties that bind our lives in place. I mean, I don't really care for all the interest they're there for. It's just you need a framework for the features on the face. Of myself, and oh, among the labels of the shit I bought, I'm not the one I'd like to be. Oh no, but I see someone else. I was looking at photos from when we were young. Your hair is light blue and you're smiling in one. And it's a strange remembrance brought on by this semblance. We were so serious, shy and experienced. Oh, so unsure of ourselves, making mistakes without anyone's help. And I thought of the ways I remember you well. Some sweet recollection of redwoods and raspberry vines. Boys, you wrote postcards to numerous times. The uncertainty then, like some sentence of sin, punctuated by moments of tenderness when there were long conversations, sharing of beds, walks home from swimming pools, giddy, impressionable, but distance grew up like the night. Decisions were silence or preemptive flight. Yeah, the queer kids I knew, we did tend to be shy. Just couldn't get over their shit. They spoke of how all their ambitions were split, but they still let you in and tried to pretend. Now you let them refer to your lovers as friends, and I wish they could see how it hurts or affirm your existence with any interested words, yeah, they're self-obsessions, a patriarch's curse. So you made a family from people you found. You grew into yourself with those weirdos around. Late nights talking at home, or dancing till dawn, or driving all day 'cause you're sick of the phone. Yeah, the good ones, they tend to leave town. It helps to write letters and say, come on down. Yeah, I'm so much better when you're around. And I think of you when I put on your old clothes. We don't talk all that often, whoever does, but I'll visit you soon and sing you a tune about finding a family somewhere in the ruins. Of the expectations we once knew, we'll try to make peace with our patriarchs too. Across my chest, says I'm only seeking glory, yeah, but glory never gives you any rest. Meets your body in an armchair, rest me to the corner of your bed, rest me in the place we share our tendernesses. There I'll rest my head. Another night lies at the end of the hallway. We'll lead you to the back of the bar with cloudy head and late for bed. You wonder where those fleeting families are. You live in somewhere on the west coast. Are you just a figment of my mind? Aren't you the one that always told me, boy, it's easier with time to be the saddest sound in a lullaby? Speck of sand in your daddy's eye. Broke my heart just so much as tried to live the life that lay before me. So you step tender when you don't run. So you surrender to everyone. So you remember the place you come to. Don't forget the world adores you. Said I'm but my body, heart and shaking skin. However will you find a safe place where you never let anyone in? To the space where you keep all your timid questions, like can I kiss you one more time before I go? And though I know the world is full of lonesome suggestions, it's us who get caught in the undertow. Don't you know, we were born on a moving train. We took form in the pouring rain. We try hard but get short of explaining that lives are for living and hearts are for changing. Yeah, forgetting is to stay the same. Not as the mountains go as they came. All these things we refuse to be framed in, from what we've been given to what's rearranging. Yeah. Someone told a story about a man who'd lived through hell and stumbled orphaned to his home to find the servants living well, and how they welcomed him like family as they plotted out some deed to kill him in his sleep and stay and satisfy their greed. A thought of who it is whose story gets remembered in the end, and through how many careful tellings does one practice their defense. Some nuances the narrator selectively omits, or one's collective memory is destined to forget. Yet we make decisions that account for the worlds that we live in. We make explanations that amount to the ones we envision. And it isn't just the horror of the way he killed those kids, that the way the tale was told explained away the deed he did. You know that everybody needs a place to live. You show your willfulness to ignorance with the counsel that you give. Your testimonial performances belie the lives you've lived. Another actor on the podium feels slighted by the ways an abstraction's been amended in some broken bygone days. Yeah, but these politics have victims. They get stuck there in the space between the weight of great ideals and the narratives they shape. It wasn't you there with a handgun, but your fax machine and pen, your personal computer, and your business acumen appeal to a notion that we all deserve what we can reach for, that what sits in your sight is a God-given right. Yes, in spite of the slights you can't speak for, sees fairness as a function of the rules that you can bend, takes action over nothing but the naked will to win.
Some definitions of our difference. Tacoma Center, 1600, suffer sleepless nights. No phone calls home to families, no reading, no Miranda rights. A second tier of prison, as if the first was not enough. It seems a citizen's great promise is a place to stretch when they lock you up. And either way they are commodifying someone. To supplies, to chains, to flows, tucked between logistic systems, a locked factory, a railroad. This billboard picture, families reunited in their homes. Buses carry unnamed inmates to unnamed jails on unnamed roads. It is a euphemistic package for apartheid. Lost from deportation trolls. $125 a bed, $125 a head. And on weekends we gathered outside of the gates just to read off the names of the dead. I must say it's a strange sense of sedition, just to show the hopes you'd hold. Contract the contradicts contrition, soulless states of stateless souls.
Your mixed metaphors conceived.
sun glow. I sit there in the sill in just a shadow. Your memory is filling up my mind. Town, you're dancing to the drummer of a new sound. I shudder when I say it doesn't bring me down, but seldom do I say a thing at all. I never thought I'd seek a separate sunshine, oh, but I get ashamed of things that should feel just fine, oh. So we sang a song about community. I only ever listen when I come and when I leave. But yeah, I'm trying to drop this habit of always apologizing. This pattern is a trap, it's agonizing. Only I will make it go away. So we can live then and focus on the moments that we live in. Leave apprehensions and the headaches that they've given. My heart beats, it has better things to say. And so I won't stumble as I follow down this path. Cause words that are spoken are just other things to have. And love you have given and your lifetime gives you back. I hope I remember.